Good morning. You're here with Vita again with Family Eats, and today our video is going to be addressing how to make a very easy artisan homemade bread. Very few steps, very few ingredients, but the end result is absolutely delicious. You will be so proud of yourself. You will love this recipe. So we're going to get started. The email address is familyeats5967@gmail.com. Feel free to tune in and please hit that thumbs up like button and please do share the video. We're ready to get started. So you're going to start out with a nice high, I prefer glass bowl. And I use my Pyrex because I can also transfer that into the oven if I want to. You want something with high sides because this is going to rise and it needs to set. Once you're done with these steps, it needs to be covered and set for a minimum of 8 hours to a maximum of 24 hours before you're ready to bake. So it's a two-step process. So today is Sunday. I'm going to prepare my dough and either late tonight or tomorrow morning, I'll be able to put my bread in the oven. That's your planning. So here we go, okay? Very, very simple. You're gonna wanna have all your stuff together and ready to go before you begin mixing. So your very first thing is going to be 3 cups of AP, all-purpose flour. Don't need to use anything fancy. And you're going to want to level off your cups. I know if you've seen any of my other videos, you know I've often said there were no measurements or book recipes per se in our house. Italians just kind of dump and go. No measuring. When you're baking, totally different story. You definitely have to make sure your measurements are precise or your recipe will not turn out for you. It's a chemistry thing. So there's your flour. Okay. Your next ingredient is going to be a teaspoon of salt. So you're just going to use some regular iodized salt. And the teaspoon sounds like a lot. It's really not. You want your bread to have flavor. You don't want it bland and tasting just like flour. So there's your teaspoon of salt. Your next is going to be active dry yeast. They usually come in envelopes of 3. Be very careful how you split the envelope so you don't cut through to the next one and spill it all over. But you'll use one envelope for, in this recipe anyway, you'll use the one envelope for an easy, I'd say, 4 or 5 loaves, because this recipe only calls for 1/2 teaspoon of yeast. So get your measurement out, 1/2 teaspoon. And this is probably my 4th loaf. So I'm just about out of this envelope, and we go to the next. This is where your item has to be extremely precise. The yeast in the water for it to bloom is what it's called. You want your yeast to bloom, so you want that to be precise. So there is your 1/2 teaspoon of yeast, and then I keep it wrapped very tightly because it's active yeast, so you don't want it loose anywhere in a drawer or a cupboard, not even in the refrigerator, that throws things off. I keep it in a nice, cool, dry place, and it's protected in here. Keep your area clean that you're working with. Okay, so we have our flour, our salt, our yeast. The next ingredient is not necessarily called for in the original recipe, but it's something that I have enjoyed doing. It gives the bread a beautiful, just a tiny hint that makes you say, what is that? Keeps it moist, and it also gives it a nice, light, sweet flavor. Now, I buy all of my raw honey from my favorite beekeeper here in Rochester, and I don't use imitation honey. I don't use store-bought honey. It's always the real deal. So I would say, adjust to your liking, but I am very comfortable with using a heaping tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half, and you just put it around the perimeter because you want that very, very warm water that's going to activate and bloom your yeast to be right on the yeast. So, like I said, I go about a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half. Honestly, once you've tried real raw honey, organic, no chemicals, no fillers, no extra liquids, you won't go back. Definitely. It's a taste all its own. It's an experience all its own. And sometimes it's okay to splurge on the important stuff like fresh honey. Always in a cool, dark place. And next comes the very warm water. You don't want it boiling, but you want it a good hot water, which is a cup and a half. And that goes right over the yeast. Once the yeast is covered, I make sure that the flour is completely covered. Now at this point, you can judge and decide if you want other flavors. If you want a nice, maybe Italian seasoned bread for Sunday dinner, mix a tablespoon of oregano and a teaspoon of onion powder and rub that right into the mix. That would make a great bread for your Sunday meal. Also, I like to use chia seeds on the very top when it's over, just for that little added crunch and a little added protein at the same time. Or you can use sunflowers on top, sunflower seeds. So everything is in here. Your warm water is grabbing that yeast. This is the tool I'm comfortable with. In every department store or grocery store, you will find a bread flour mill. So you're just going to gently, not vigorously, go around your bowl to combine it. And you'll start to see it puff and bloom a bit. At this point, you don't want to go crazy and work hard, gently. You want those glutens to all get working, but you don't want to make your bread tough, because this artisan bread already, by design, is a dense bread. It's not a light, airy bread. This is a very dense bread when it's cooked. So we're just about combined here. Make sure you get right down to the bottom. That's what this here is for. Use your thumb to really maneuver this gently through lots of folds. At about this point, it's going to be very sticky. It's going to be warm. Wipe it down right off your tool. And at this point, it's a good time to make sure your rings are removed, because now it's going to get a little messy and fun. So now you want to make sure your hands are good and floured. So have a cup of flour handy right on your working surface to coat your hands. And you're going to want to get in there. Don't be afraid of it. Reach down, make sure your fingertips are constantly floured, and grab it and turn it and get all of the flour, all of the bits in the bottom, and just turn it and grab it and fold it only 2-3 times tops. Go back around, just make sure you've incorporated all of that flour, gently push it down in, not heavy kneading, no bread machine, no mixer, good old-fashioned hands, it's all you need. Wipe your hands down and clean. Needless to say, you want to start with very clean, scrubbed hands before you start this recipe. At this point, you're going to take a little more flour, loose flour, and rub it into your hands. And you're going to grab one last time, fold it, and then flip it. And I'll show you what this looks like. You need the high sides so that when it blooms, it has plenty of room to bloom, plenty of aeration within the holes of the bread. That's what it's going to look like. Nothing else. You do nothing else. We wrap it. And I'm going to show you how we do that. You need cellophane and a rubber band. And you're going to grab a good, healthy piece. Press it tight on one end. You want to get a good seal on this. You don't want any loose edges. You want to stretch it good and tight around your bowl like this. No air. Take your rubber band. Now in my case, I got to go around the handle. Make sure it's good and tight around it. Got a nice area for it to bloom up to. But what you're doing here is you're creating a tent or a greenhousing kind of effect. You're going to keep all that heat and moisture, and when the yeast starts to bubble and activate, it's going to rise, and this is going to rise all the way up. It's going to be bubbly. It's going to be sticky. It's supposed to be. We're going to set this on the counter in a cool, dark spot for a minimum of 8 hours, a maximum of 24, and when I come back, we'll do the next step. See you tomorrow. Bon appetit. We're back here at the Family Eats with our next day, next step to our beautiful artisan homemade bread. And I told you the condensation will build up. And this has been going for 18 hours. And I told you that it needs to rest a minimum of 8 hours or a maximum of 24. Remove the cover. Don't let the condensation fall back in because it's very wet. It's going to be sticky and wet and bubbly, and it's supposed to be. That's not wrong. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is make sure that your glass pan, metal pan, whatever you're going to cook this in, whatever shape it is that you want, is in the oven and warming. You preheat the oven at 450 with the sprayed, with nonstick sprayed container in the oven. You want that container good and hot when you add your bread to it. It's just the way it's done. This is a very dense bread. As I said, this is not a light, airy, fluffy bread. And this is part of the process. So the oven is preheating now as we speak while we're working. So the very next thing you're gonna do, remove your rings, obviously. They're going to get ruined if you don't. And you're going to flour your surface. Save some. You're going to need it for your hands to get around. So this is my very next step. I take and make sure that my fingertips are totally covered. And you're going to go around the bowl. And just pull it away from its sides. Don't be afraid of what you're doing to it. It's okay. You're not going to overwork this, though, because your bread will be extra tough. Won't rise as nicely. You don't want to handle it more than you have to. Take a little sprinkle right on top to maneuver it around. Take this up. Okay. As I said, very sticky. I'm going to do this next step, and I'm going to come back to the video because this next step is shape it into a ball like this, and we're going to let it rest for a minimum of 20 minutes. Some say 30. I like 20. Don't need it that long. See the nice perfect round, because we have chosen a round glass dish that we're going to cook it in or bake it in. So I cover it with flour while the oven is preheating. It'll set for a little bit. Comes out clean, see? While the oven is preheating, this is going to rest. It'll rise a little bit in that time, but because we've handled it and moved around the glutens again, it needs to rest a bit. The next step will be to slightly wet the surface just slightly. Do not soak this. Last thing you want to do. And then I take my chia seeds and apply them. You don't have to. This is what this loaf is going to be, though. It's got protein in the chia seeds and a little extra added crunch. Every bread can be totally different, especially the topping. So like I said, you just let that rest for 20 to 30 minutes, and your oven is preheating in the meantime, and we will be right back. Welcome back. Our 20 minutes has passed, and our dough has rest for that amount of time, and it's just nice and pillowy. I'm going to want to throw a little bit of flour over top for handling. Our Pyrex dish has been in the oven at 450. I know that sounds high, but it is what it is. This is the recipe, so you're going to need to make sure that you pick the container to cook it in that works for you, whether it be the shape or the content of it to withstand that. Some people like to use the crock from their slow cooker, and that works as well. You just make sure you put a cold crock into a cold oven and do the preheat. Don't preheat your oven to 450 and then try to put something cold in there. You're going to have an issue unless you're using metal. Always make sure that it's sprayed before it goes in. And this is the next step. I'm going to take that out of the oven gently. Close the oven back up so you don't lose any temperature. It's very hot, needless to say. So carefully, you're going to flour your hands. You're going to take your beautiful bread, plop it in the middle, let it go. You're going to hear a slight sizzle. Tiny bit of flour for the top. This bread cooks for 30 minutes at this temperature, covered. Now, if you have a covered dish that domes up high enough, that would work fine. If not, put your foil on, make sure it's closed up, gently pick it back up, get it into your hot oven, just like this. Do not forget to set your timer for 30 minutes to bake at 450. After that, you're going to remove the foil gently, and you're going to lower the oven to 400, reset the timer for 15 minutes. So that's uncovered for the last extra 15 minutes. So you bake for 30 covered, bake for 15 uncovered, drop your temperature down to 400. Once I've done that, what I like to do, I prefer a very crunchy, crispy top. So what I like to do is shut the oven, leave the bread in there, open the door ajar, and let the oven cool down before I remove that bread. Then I take it out, set it on the counter, let it cool completely, run a butter knife around it, and we'll remove it. And I'll show you that when we come back and we take the bread out and show you how to store it. Hi, so we're back. I want to show you the end result. This is the last step of our beautiful homemade artisan bread. It has baked the full time. It has cooled down in the oven like we talked about. And I want to show you the finished product. Can you see this? Look at how beautiful that bread is. So, still warm, obviously. You're going to loosen. Sometimes you don't have to, but I sprayed it enough where I don't really have to, but you'll have a butter knife out, and you're going to want to loosen it. Have a nice, clean, lightweight linen towel. Is how I like to start. That's how I like to bring it to full room temperature before I wrap it with either cellophane to keep it very soft if you don't want the real hard crustiness. Listen. Can you hear that? I like that. My family likes that. So, we take this out. There's your bottom. Beautiful round loaf of bread. For either your dinner, you can cut this open and have this be your bread dip bowl. Slice the top all the way across, cut out a big circle of all the inside, cube up the bread, put it around on a platter, fill it with your favorite dip if you choose. If not, this is a beautiful dinner-sized loaf of crusty bread. It's got your chia seeds still on it. There's no gloss or shine on this one like in previous breads that I've shown you. Because there's sometimes I don't want all of that moisture on the crust. I want it to be a nice dry crust. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. Please stay till the very end and you will see the address for my email to obtain this written recipe as well. And I appreciate you giving me a thumbs up. And please do share my video. And we'll see you again next time. Have a great day. Bon appetit.